Watch her took it to town. Baby bet, ayy,
couple racks, ayy. Assalamualaikum and good evening. Today we are from Group 11. We would like to present our final project for Islamic Institution. And my name is Aina Natasha binti Muhammad Aisha. ID number PA18043. And my group members are Syahmi Fadlan bin Zahari, Rubiatu Fazliza binti Muhammad Rashidi, Siti Najiha binti Muharraf, and Nurul Shazwani binti Othman. According to previous study by Rafiki and Wahab in 2014, religion is one of the most powerful social institutions with a strong influence on people's attitudes, values and action. It explains the unique impact on organizational matters such as managers and employees' approach and decisions. Islamic institutions help us to have a deeper understanding of the basic function of Islamic principles such as values, ethics, characteristic management tools and concept in organization. It also helps us to increase knowledge and on Islamic principles and decision making while managing an organization. Thus, in order to deepen our understanding, our group has chosen a Muslim manager, which is Encik Muhammad Fazil bin Abdul Rahman, worked as a general manager at Johor Tenggara Fairfax Berhad and has served in the company for almost 15 years as our subject to identify the practice of the philosophy and characteristic of Islamic institution in the organization in order to have an ability and characteristic to adopt Islamic ethics in managing activities in the organization in future. So Mr. Fazil was approached through email address and exchanged phone number and agreed to participate in the interview session. So we agreed to meet for the interview on an online platform, which is Google Meet, and the interview went well. So for the data collection, there are 7 questions has been asked to Encik Fazil, which is as stated in the slide. So for background of the industry, the FELCRA was initially established as a statutory body in 1966, and in 1997, the statutory body ceased to be evolving into a whole own government corporate company. As of July 2020, FELCRA Berhad has developed 2,250 hectares of farm on behalf of 111 and 462,000 participants encompassing 1,049 consolidation and rehabilitation projects as well as 33,145 hectares of estate owned by FELCRA Berhad. The mission of the FELCRA Berhad is to become a social enterprise powerhouse in the agriculture and food sector. The mission is first protecting the interests of participants, encompassing economic and social aspects, secondly, driving agricultural technology, and thirdly, championing the national food security agenda. The objective of FELCRA Berhad is firstly to enhance the quality of life focus groups such as the participants' community as well as FELCRA Berhad's human capital. Secondly, improve productivity levels through latest technologies in efficient management. Thirdly, enhance the company's value-added economy. And lastly, offer high return value on developed plantations. According to Mr. Fazil, for the staffing information, at the Johor Tenggara FELCRA Berhad has 30 employees and encompasses of 4 administrative workers and 26 plantation workers. Next. For the business activities at the Johor Tenggara FELCRA Berhad firstly to operate the oil palm plantation of FELCRA participants. Secondly, present the achievement and any benefit that can be obtained by FELCRA participants toward the management of FELCRA on their land. And then thirdly, to create agricultural land development schemes in rural areas. And fourthly, to provide training and skills to rural communities in developing agricultural lands. And lastly, create an agricultural land development plan scheme that is specifically for rural youth who do not have jobs and fixed income through the Youth Land Plan program. And here is the organizational structure for FELCRA Berhad Johor Tenggara. There are 2 departments in this Johor Tenggara FELCRA Berhad, which is Administration Department and Plantation Department. Each department has their own activity, which is the Administration Department provide administrative and technical support in the areas of human resource, budgetary, strategic planning, legal affairs, call for tenders, facilities and security. For the focus of plantation department is to plan and identify potential areas for ideal land development to develop oil palm plantation to generate income and more job opportunity towards participants of labor. Next, I pass to my team members.
PA1808. I will continue to the presentation with the next part, which is the uses of Islamic principles and characteristics in organization. Islamic principles must be implemented in workplace management by applying the teachings of Quran and Sunnah to achieve both the short-term and long-term organization goals. Based on the interview with Mr. Fazil, he mentioned some of the Islamic principles that had been applied in the organization. The first Islamic principle that this company applied is the element in Sunnah, which Mr. Fazil applied into the organization management, which is punctuality. Punctuality is very important to a manager and worker. Being punctual shows that a person is disciplined. For Mr. Fazil, punctuality is important for managing organization in following Sunnah. It is to develop the worker to be ready for any task ahead and show that the worker is disciplined and dedicated to working for the company. Next, creating a good atmosphere while working, and this can be achieved by always helping each other when there are some who need help. As a manager, Mr. Fazil monitor every worker under him and always ask if there were problems or any dissatisfaction with work, and he also conducted a meeting with his team every month. The workers are also allowed to give and share their comments or feedback so that it can improve the work process in future. By doing this, not only they can help each other, but also can strengthen their bond, hence can create a good teamwork and good work environment. Next point is prayer. Mr. Fazil also said that they always perform solat fardu together, and if there are any events or gatherings, they will definitely start with doa, salawat and praises to Allah Subhanahu Wa Taala. He said that by doing this, it can implement the Islamic management in their workplace. This also will create a good relationship between workers and employers, and also the business will get barakah because it uses an Islamic way being taken care of, and this can motivate the workers to work more efficiently. Next, I will continue with the strategy used by the organization to sustain the industry and to meet customer satisfaction. Every organization must strive for excellence in planning and implementation, besides the main purpose to achieve our smart adaptation. Velcro sedia berbagai macam strategis to sustain in industry and to meet customer satisfaction. There are some of the strategies mentioned by Mr. Fazil in the interview. First one is through the product. Majority of the customers are looking for high quality product that is durable and able to perform what has been claimed by the marketers through their promotional activities. In this case, offering high quality product is the priority for the marketers as to ensure the customers are satisfied with their product. In fact, in Islam, no low quality product should be offered along with good quality product as to deceive customers. It is to project the right expectation of the customers that a high quality product will lead to the customer satisfaction. And second one is through branding. The main strategies that have been the focal point of marketing success in the 21st century is branding. Building a sense of confidence and trust towards a certain brand is the key to long-lasting relationship between the business and the customer. Marketers or businesses can apply such strategy and build up their brand by projecting a good character, a good conduct in business, being truthful and honest as a person. This needs to be spread all across the organization, not only to the marketing department, but also in all members of the business organization. The point is through pricing. It is critical to have reasonable and ethical pricing for a product, since it is the most sensitive issue when offering a product to a target market. Although there is no excellent ruling suggesting how to charge customers for a certain product and service, prices should have moral and ethical justification guided by Islamic principles such as justice. As said in Islam, price control must not be excessive and price fixing is prohibited since it will affect the market mechanism which is determined by the interaction of demand and supply. And the last one is through advertising. This can be monitored by having an internal committee in marketing department that filter out elements of advertising that are not in line with Sharia. The Sharia Observation Committee should have the authority to filter inappropriate elements to be presented to the target audience. Elements of Islamic teaching must be applied into the advertisement. It is vital to have such internal committee within the business to monitor the promotional activities, particularly in advertising. Next, I will pass to the next student.
I will explain about the differences and similarities about the implementation of Islamic institution principle characteristic in industries compared with the theory in Islamic institution. The difference is as a for theory in Islam take a comprehensive approach to the individual. Islam, which is based on individual and society morality and accountability, brought us about the social revolution in the setting in which it was initially built. The difference is that the theory focuses solely on a person's personal career success, whereas the industry requires the collaboration from everyone to reach the excellence. However, the similarity about the implementation of Islamic institution principle in this company compared with the theory in Islamic institution is it is the parallels between the key idea that they both established on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, whom we must obey and follow. Okay, next slide. About the effect of implementation of Islamic institution principle or characteristic towards the organizational excellence. Based on the interview session with the Mr. Fadil, his company encouraged the employees to solat berjemaah at the workplace. Every week they will recite the Surah Yasin and they will invite the amal zakat during the Ramadan, always do gotong royong and participate in motivational session or team building. The importance of prayer is not only training the nature of discipline, but only building the value of integrity in oneself. Praying together at workplace is beneficial towards the organization as it promotes love and unity among Muslims. Besides that, every week, Zakat Berhad workers will recite the Surah Yasin. As we all know, there are many benefits of reciting the Surah Yasin, and one of them is help in life issues. Reciting the Yasin every day helps the solving the problem in this world life. Then this organization also invite the Amal Zakat on every Ramadan. Zakat Fitrah is one of the fardu ain obligation on every Muslim. The duty performed in the month of the Ramadan aims to cleanse the and purify the souls of those who fast from useless things, and then the payment of Fitrah can be used to help the poor and needy to prepare for the Hari Raya. This culture is wonderful because it allows Muslims to fulfill their obligation while working. Next, the gotong royong is one of the out of the ideas to build a strong workplace community. When employees feel to they are working within a community of like-minded co-workers and managers, their work become more meaningful. Lastly, the employee motivation is critical to any company's success. A highly motivated workforce translates a highly productive workforce. all of which will aid in the achievement of corporate objectives. In the interview, Mr. Fazil explained that his organization always conduct a motivational talk and encourage their workers to participate in team building programs. A motivational talk at the workplace usually focus on personal, emotional and professional development. Okay, that's all for me. I will pass to the next presenter.
All the career experience such as club and intercentral volunteer,
So for the conclusion, we highlighted three important significant from the interview with Mr. Fazil. In conclusion, we focuses and highlighted based on what we gained from the interview. The first thing that always got in our mind is that to achieve both short and long-term organizational goals, Islamic principle must be integrated in workplace management by implementing the teaching of the Quran and Sunnah. Any organization wishing to use Islamic values in strategy planning must adhere to Sharia rules. The notion of ihsan or excellence is described in the Sharia as including the efficient and successful administration of organization. Secondly, employees. For the employees, they must consider other people's feelings when adopting Islamic institution values in industries. The difference is that the theory is primarily concerned with a person's professional achievement. In the context in which it was first revealed, Islam, which is founded on individual and societal morality and accountability, ushered in social revolution. We found it is very amazing that every week Felkara Berhad employees will recite Surah Yasin, as mentioned by the previous presenter. Every Muslim has a fardhu ain commitment to pay Zakat Fitrah, and this activity is truly should be an example of a great company. So, for the last one, for graduates like us students, during the interview it is said that employers are having a difficult time hiring individuals with a varied set of talent to assist them in facilitating and improving the efficiency of their organizations. To get professional assistance, they must network with professional, fellow student, committee members and mentors. To sum up, basically we graduate has to have a self-initiative to compete among others. So that's all from us. Thank you very much.
That's